Sound design.
So as I was doing those previous videos, I kept getting kind of disappointed that I was running out of headroom on my microphone preamp. I kept wanting to turn it up more and more to make sure that I could get 20 dB of headroom between the noise floor and my measurement signal in the room across the frequency range, but I kept running out of headroom in the very, very low frequencies. So I started wondering, what would I need to do to make sure that I always had enough headroom? And I realized, well, I just need to make sure that whatever the loudest signal is gonna be, that I start out 20 dB below that. So here is an alternative method that I might start using in the field to make sure that I always have enough headroom. So I have my giant input meters open here to make this really easy. And it's gonna take just a couple more steps of back and forth setting the level in the room to really make this work. So first of all, over here in my X32, I have the volume all the way down. Okay, so no volume's going into the room, but the tap is coming before this fader for the reference loop. So when I turn on the signal gen here, I should still be able to see it. Yep, there we go. So here's my reference. This is 0 dB of pink noise right now. What I want to make sure is that I can go 20 deep, have 20 dB of headroom to basically do whatever I want. And to make this even more clear, I'm going to set this to a sine wave for now. Okay, so if this is 0 dB and I've got this sine wave going here, then as I look over here at my microphone preamp, I can see that it's turned all the way down. And if I start to turn it up, then it's gonna go into clipping, right? Okay, so if I wanna stay out of the red and stay in a safe zone, even if I go all the way up to zero on my signal generator, then I'll probably just leave this all the way down. Okay, that seems safe. Now I know that I can start at minus 20 dB and I'll have minus 20 dB here, and over here I set this trim already so that it also wouldn't go into clipping, and you can see here that they match, which is nice. So minus 20 dB on my input, minus 20 dB on the signal generator, and again, I see that I can go all the way up. I'm not clipping my input on my console. I'm not clipping the input meters of my audio interface. So I should be able to do whatever I want as long as I set the correct volume now in the room. So let's go back down to 20 dB. And what I want to do first is just take a measurement of the noise floor in the room and then turn the signal up so that I make sure I get at least above the noise floor at minus 20 dB. So minus 20 dB will be my minimum level so that I'm above the noise floor throughout the frequency range that I'm measuring, and then all the way up to zero will be my 20 dB of headroom that I need to make sure that I get maximum coherence in my transfer function, right? I'll just turn up my microphone gain here to just kind of a random amount at this point so I can just take a measurement. And I'll stop talking and we will get a measurement of the noise floor in the room right now. Now I'm going to start bringing up the signal in the room. That's this fader over here. And I don't want sine, I want pink. Down to 50 hertz, I am well above the noise floor. Okay, so this will be my minimum measurement spot. And here on my console, that's minus 15. Okay, I'll just sort of note those and remember those. And now that I have the level set in the room, now I can actually match my microphone preamp to my reference input. So let's do that. I would like to do that with a sine. Hopefully it doesn't kill me. Okay, so now I'm matched my reference to my measurement in the room. That way, when I go to my transfer function, I've got a measurement that is around the 0 dB line, right? And now I should be able to go from minus 20 dB up to 0 and get maximum coherence if I need to. So let's just take a look at that. It's going to be pretty loud here in the room. We'll see if I can stand it. All right, so it worked. Here's a noise floor. I'm at my minimum measurement level here, minus 20 dB. I am above the noise floor at all frequencies, down to 50 hertz. Now, we know that for me to get maximum coherence, I'm gonna need to be at least 20 dB above the noise floor. So let's do an offset of our noise floor and then see what we have to turn our measurement up to. Throughout most of the frequency range, I'm already above the noise floor. I'm already 20 dB above the noise floor. It's really in these low frequencies that now I'm covered up. So let's take a look at that. So I guess my question is, how high do I need to go? And I know I can go up to 0, and that may be what I need to do. It's getting pretty loud in the room, so let's turn on our pseudo-random below 150 and just look at that. Okay, so yes, it does look like I would need to turn it all the way up to 0 dB if I want to get above those cars driving by in the low frequencies here down to 44. And it looks like probably below 40, the speaker isn't doing much anyway. All right, so let's review this test. If I want to make sure that I can get 20 dB above the noise floor, then what I need to do is start at minus 20 on my signal generator in the room, turn up my sound system until I'm above the noise floor throughout the frequency range, and then I know that I'll have that headroom, okay? And I just need to make sure that my reference and my measurement microphone inputs are matched on the preamps at that point. So I know there was a lot of jumping around in this video. What I'll try and do in the description below this video is I'll write all of these steps out step by step so that it's probably a little bit more obvious than this whole video. Anyway, let me know what you think about this process. Maybe you're doing something like this in the field already, and maybe you have something, maybe a little bit more simplified version of this. But I hope this is helpful for you.
Sound design. Live.